حسن
Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
In Christos, Christos, ben chois.
I have sinned, forgive me.
Sleel.
Evi bros of Christos, ite.
Irini pasi.
Et omnem mate.
Marin shebeh moten tot fin beref erbethanef o hnait if noti if yotim ben shois o ben noti o ben sutir isu o spi echeristus je af eris kipazini gun af ervoithineron af areh eron af subteneruf af tiesu eron Of Titotin of Intensha Ehri Etai Onothai, and Thof on Marin Tiho Eir of Hopos, and Tef Areh Eron, Hen Pai Eho Eth Oab Fai, Namne Eho Tiro, and Tepen on. Chen hirin in iven in jepi bantu karatu or pshois pennuti.
Kirie leiso.
O Master Lord God the bantu karatur. The Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything, concerning everything and in everything, for you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion on us, hear us, help us, and accept the supplications and prayers of his saints, for that which is on good on our behalf at all times, and to keep the life and standing of our honored father, the archpriest, Papa Todros II, and his partner in the liturgy, our father, the bishop, and the Youssef, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men, and the rising up of enemies hidden and manifest, take them away from us and from all your people, and from this church, and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable, do provide for us, for it is you have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and upon all the power of the enemy.
Κύριε ελέησον τεν ως τε με διόν τε με τσί ειρήνε εμπεμνε μασόν τε τριές τε σοβεν ομόν σε ως σερετή η εκκλησέ ει αμή εν τένιον αγγελός σερετή πάρθε Sitos ben sotir Serene more Iotie serombie Este o sine sos misino Neme muti Vilogon Serene more Iachen O sere Efo web Serene more Iotmos Empieto web
Maria, soy, soy, no, 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 no,
Irini pasi
eto pneumatien son letasas kagandaman to kra tor the father of our lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the souls of your servants who have fallen asleep, our fathers and our brethren.
Pray for our fathers and brethren who have fallen asleep and frozen in the faith of Christ since the beginning. Our holy fathers, the archbishops, our fathers, the bishops, our fathers, the hegumens, our fathers, the priests, our brethren, the deacons, our fathers, the monks, our fathers, the laymen, the full pros of Christians, that Christ our souls in paradise with joy, and we too accord mercy unto us, and forgive us our sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Graciously, O Lord, repose all their souls in the bosom of our holy fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Sustain them in a green pasture beside still waters, in the paradise of joy, the place out of which grief, sorrow, and groaning have filled away, in the light of your sins. Raise up their bodies also in the day which you have appointed, according to your true promises, which are without lie. Grant them the good things of your promises, that which an eye has not seen, nor ear hear, neither have come upon the heart of man, the things which you, God, have prepared for those who love your holy name. For there is no death for your servants, but a departure. Of the Christian who are in the whole world, from the east to the west, and from north to south, each one according to his name, and each one according to her name. For no one is pure and without blemish, even though his life on earth be a single day. As for those, O Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them, and may they be worthy of the kingdom of the heavens. As for us all, grant us our Christian perfection that would be pleasing to you, and give them and us a share and inheritance with all your saints.
Lord, have mercy.
Graciously accord, O Lord, to keep us this night without sin. Blessed are you, O Lord, God of our fathers, and exceedingly blessed and glorified be your name forever. Amen. Let your mercy, O Lord, be upon us according to our hope in you. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you have given their food in due season. Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hope of our ends of the earth. And you, O Lord, keep us safe from this generation forever. Amen. Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Blessed are you, O Lord, make me understand your commandments. Blessed are you, O Lord, enlighten me with the righteousness. Your mercy, O Lord, endures forever. Despise not, O Lord, the works of your hands. You have been my refuge from generation to generation. I asked the Lord and said, have mercy on me. Hear my soul, for I have sinned against you. Lord, I have fled unto you. Save me and teach me to do well. For you are my God, and with you is the fountain of life. In your light shall we see light. Let your mercy come unto those who know you, and your righteousness unto their pride and heart. To you belongs blessing. To you belongs glory. O Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, existing and living now and forever and ever. Amen. It is good to give thanks to the Lord and sing praises unto your name, O Most High. Show forth your mercy every morning and righteousness every night. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, was born the Virgin, have mercy upon us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, which cried for us, have mercy upon us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, who rose from the dead and sent to heaven, have mercy upon us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto the age of all ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, forgive us our sins. O Lord, forgive us our iniquities. O Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, visit the Christian people for the sake of your name. Our Father, by the mouth sleep, O Lord, repose their souls. Hear with us, O Lord, have mercy on us. You are with us, O Lord, perceive supplications. Prayers to the glory of the name of the triple holiness. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Amen.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done
on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespass, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. In Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Be Christos, he souls been choice. Amen. Alleluia. Share in it, and to rule us, who have us, men all.
Lift up our prayers unto your beloved Son, that he may forgive us our sins.
Ask
the Lord on our behalf, that he may mercy on our souls and forgive us our sins.
Intercede
on our behalf before Christ, whom we bore, that he may forgive us our sins.
As David
has said in the book of Psalms, the queen stood at your right hand, O King.
Solomon moti eros chen bi goin teni gojita sonio taj miri tabulisimi Jerusalem.
For he has given us symbol of her and many high names, saying, come out of your garden, O choicest aroma.
Sherene oti varsenus yoro emmien alisine, Sherep shushun te bengenus ari egmonan in Emmanuel.
We ask you to remember us, O our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
Shashvin arshi angelosi o erato everem nosim biem thompi pantokerato et shimshim mysterione thim.
Michael is the first, Gabriel is the second, Raphael is the third, a symbol of the Trinity.
Soriel, Sedakiel, Sarathiel, Mananiel, Nainishten, Erdronies, Onwebni, Tovim, Obirivishen, Bison.
The Cherubim and the Seraphim, the thrones and minions and powers, the four incorporeal creatures carrying the throne of God.
Bigotef toem everens viteros kentiklis entenishur bimmi sevohoserom chenometatmo evoshevolev goemmos.
Holy God, heal the sick. Holy mighty, O Lord, repose the soul asleep.
Agios athanatos es moete kikliron omeia mare beknainim tegirini oyens of them beklaos.
Holy, 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 O Lord of us, heaven and earth are full of your glory and honor.
Avshan gosim yalilo yasharinani fio emmo
intercede on our behalf, O angelic armies and heavenly orders, that
he may forgive us our sins.
Marcus be apostolos of the evangelistis, be metre chaniem, ente be monogenis in noti.
You have come and enlightened us through your gospel, and taught us the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Akintene volchenev kaki echone bi oinim mi aktimonim bi oin kentevon et avive siti volchened me.
All the tribes of the earth were blessed through you, and your words have reached the ends of the world.
Shere nakom yuartiro, shere mi evangelisti, shere mi apostolos, Marcos bithi orimos.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf, O beholder of God, the evangelist. Say, Mark the apostle, that he may forgive us our sins.
Shashvin rombam gonki, volinje vies moab georgios, erebesh bin oronan omos, efti habirofim mini.
They could not change his mind, nor his upright faith, nor his great love for Christ the King.
Ereb salim nem David, jav kotiro injini ens mostiro, Allah nevrani nisos benut, aichim efshif shish nimo.
For great is your honor, O George, my Lord and Prince, for Christ rejoices in you, the heavenly Jerusalem.
Shere nakobi martiro, shere bitchoy gengeneo, shere biat loforos, bashoy sepuruga orgeos.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf, O Christ bearer and martyr, George, my Lord and Prince, that he may forgive us our sins.
Show me in Tora son segon, can he match you see Tarakin Hito, ten chosen if they rent it auto, cause it to embarrass and sins in union.
Ask of him whom you have borne, our good Savior, to take away our trouble and grant us his peace.
Share in the Varsenus yoroim min alinsini, sherep shoshon te bengenus ariegmon alimmanoil.
We ask you to remember us, our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
We exalt you, the Mother of the True Light. We glorify you, Saint Theotokos, who have brought forth unto us the Savior of the whole world. He came and saved our souls. Glory be to our Master, our King, Christ, the pride of the apostles, the crown of the martyrs, the joy of the righteous, the firmness of the churches, the forgiveness of sin. We proclaim the Holy Trinity and one Godhead. We worship him, we glorify him. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, bless us, amen. Truly we believe in one God, God the Father, the Pontificator, Creator, creator of heaven and earth, and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, but one essence with the Father, by whom all things are made, who for us men for our salvation came down from heaven, was incarnated of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary, and became man. And he was crucified for us from Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried on the third day, rose from the dead, according to the scriptures, sent to heaven. He sits at the hand of his Father, then he's coming again in his glory, judging the living and dead, his kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, receives from the Father, Son, and worshiped and glorified, and spoke by the prophets. And in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, we confess our sins and remission of sin.
Ten God Shevon Chayin Ten Tiana Sasi
have mercy Puna.
Men have desired to see the things you see and have not seen them, and to hear the things you hear and have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. May you be worthy to hear and to act according to your holy gospels through the prayers of your saints.
Pray for the holy gospel.
Lord have mercy.
Remember also our Master, all those who have bidden us to remember them in our supplications and prayers, which we offer up unto you, O Lord our God. Those who have already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them. For you are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
A psalm of David say, Alleluia. I will wait on your name, for it is good before or your sins. I have trusted in the mercy of God forever, even forevermore. Alleluia.
Of all with you,
Zmara utin jevi ethni yochen efran im abshoyz enteni gum kiriye flogi sonik tu kata lo kan ageyu ef angeliu tu anagnos ma بن سوتير أمو بن أورو تيرين إيسوس بإخريستوس إبشيري أمفنوتي إتقن بي أقو نفشائني So he told a parable to those who were invited when he noted how they chose the best places saying to them When you are invited by anyone to a wedding feast do not sit down in the best place Lest one more honorable than you be invited by him, and he who invited you and him come and say to you, Give place to this man, and then you begin with shame to take the lowest place. But when you are invited, go and sit down in the lowest place, so that when he who invited you comes, he may say to you, Friend, go up higher, then you will have glory in the presence of those who sit at the table with you. For whoever exalts himself will be abased, and he who humbles himself will be exalted. Then he also said to him who invited him, When you give a dinner or a supper, Do not ask your friends, your brothers, your relatives, nor your rich neighbors, lest they also invite you back and you be repaid. But when you give a feast, invite the poor, the maimed, the lame, the blind, and you will be blessed because they cannot repay you, for you shall be repaid at the resurrection of the just. Now when one of those who sat at the table with him heard these things, he said to him, Blessed is he who shall eat bread in the kingdom of God.
Glory be to God
Intercede on our behalf, O Lydios, O the Theotokos, Mary, the Mother of our Savior, they may forgive us our sins.
O Vehemet Shoisere, Egonobiat Loporos, and Martyron, Beshoisep, Uru Georgios, and Tefkanin Novi, Manevol.
Blessed be the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the perfect Trinity. We worship Him and glorify Him.
Shlil.
Vivros of Christothite.
Irini Pasi. Again, let us ask God, the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the peace of your one only holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church.
If
for the peace of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Orthodox Church.
Lord have mercy.
This which exists from one end of the world to the other. Our Patriarch and Father, the High Priest, Pope Ava Tawadros II, and his spiritual brother, and the Patriarch of Antioch, Mary Agnatus Ibrahim II, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Abuna Antonius, and his partner, Apostolic Liturgy, our Father, the Bishop, Mbe Youssef.
First peace, Pope Ava Tawadros II, of the great city of Alexandria, and his spiritual brother in the Apostolic Liturgy, the Patriarch of Joseph from the Second, and the Patriarch of Eritrea, Bon Antonius, and his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Orthodox Bishop.
Lord have mercy.
Keep them secure for us for many years and peaceful times. Remember, O Lord, the salvation of this your holy place and in every place, and in every monastery of our Orthodox fathers.
Pray for the salvation of the world, and of the city of ours, and of all cities, sisters, sons, and monasteries.
Lord have mercy.
And every city and every country, and all the villages and their adornment, and save us all from famine, plague, earthquake, drawing fire, captivity by barbarian, the sword of the stranger, and the rising up of heretics.
Lord have mercy.
Graciously accord, O Lord, the waters of the river this year to bless them.
Of the waters of the river this year, that Christ our God may bless them and raise them according to their measure, that he may give fruit to all the faith of the earth, sustain us, the sons of men, save the cattle, and forgive us our sins.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Raise them to their measure according to your grace, give joy to the face of the earth. May its forests be abundantly watered and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting, manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness for the sake of the poor of your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat you and seek your holy name, for the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh, fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we do, having sufficiency in everything, always may abound in every good deed.
Lord have mercy.
Dear Jesus Christ, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Pray for this holy church and for our assemblies.
Lord, have mercy.
Grant that they may be to us without obstacle or hindrance, that we hold them according to your holy and blessed will. Houses of prayer, houses of purity, houses of blessings, grant them to us, O Lord, and your servants who will come after us forever. Arise, O Lord God, let all your enemies be scattered, and let all who hate your holy name flee before your face. But let your people be in blessing, thousands of thousands, and 10,000 times 10,000, doing your will, our Father, our Savior.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil one. In Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever. Amen. Be Christos in stones ben choice.
So skifulos imun to kirklinate.
En obion so kireen.
Bruce, amen, diem et amen.
Kirini Pasi.
Et omne vmonti insun.
O Master Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son and Logos of God the Father, who has broken every bond of our sins through his life-giving sufferings, who breathed in the face of his holy disciples and saintly apostles and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. You are now also our Master. Through your holy apostles have given grace to those for a time labor in the priesthood in your holy church to forgive sins upon the earth and to bind and to loose bond of iniquities. We ask and entreat your goodness, O Lover of mankind, for your servant, those who bow their heads before your holy glory. Dispense unto us your mercy, loose your wound for our iniquities, if we have committed any sin against you, knowingly or unknowingly, through anxious heart, or in deed, or in word, or from faint-heartedness. O Master, who knows the weakness of men, as a good one and lover of mankind, O God, grant us and forgive our sins. Bless us, absolve us, and all your people. Fill us with your fury, straighten us unto your goodwill. For you are our God, and glory, honor, dominion, and worship are due to you, together with the good Father, Holy Spirit, now and forever, on the age of ages. Amen.
Amen. Kiriya laison, kiriya laison, kiriya laison.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. We will continue tonight our Bible study from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 5, starting from verse 27 to the end of the chapter. Verse 27. After these things, he went out and saw a tax collector named Levi sitting at the tax office, and he said to him, follow me. So he left all, rose up, and followed him. Levi traditionally is identified also as Saint Matthew. So Saint Matthew has two names, Levi or Matthew. He was a tax collector. And the name Matthew means the gift of God. Actually, when our Lord Jesus Christ calls such a man tax collector, and they were known with their greed, their violence, their wickedness. To call him to be one of his followers, and then one of the 12, the very inner circle around our Lord Jesus Christ, this reveals the purpose of the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. He came to redeem all men. All men. He did not, as he said, I did not come to call righteous, but to call sinners to repentance. The Lord did not look upon the outward appearance. If he was choosing people based on the outward appearance, he would choose from the Pharisees, from the scribes, from the religious leaders of Israel. But God was looking at the genuine character of men, looking at the heart. Many people from outside were sinners, but they were waiting for just a touch of grace, and their life will be converted completely. Matthew was one of these people who was a sinner, but once the grace of God touched him, he converted completely. And actually, as I told you, Matthew means gift of God. And indeed, Matthew was a gift of God to the Christian faith. Why I'm saying this? You know, he wrote his gospel to the Jews. And what helped him to write his gospel to the Jews? His scholarly knowledge of the Old Testament, his intimate understanding of the Pharisees and Sadducees, his ability to penetrate the falsehood of the religious hierarchy of that era. All these things actually provided Matthew with unique gifts which enabled the Jews. We read before, when God called the four fishermen, Peter, Andrew, James, and John, immediately they left everything and followed him. In the same way, Levi demonstrates his genuine repentance by turning away from his old life to follow the Christ. Once Christ told him, follow me, he left all and followed him. No doubt such a decision was not an easy decision. It needs actually determination, self-denial, full trust and confidence in God before making such decision. Verse 29, then Levi gave him a great feast in his own house, and there were a great number of tax collectors and others who sat down with them. And their scribes and the Pharisees complained against his disciples, saying, why do you eat and drink with tax collectors and sinners? We can see here the integrity and the sincerity of this great apostle, Saint Matthew. His integrity and sincerity were quickly evidenced by the dinner which he gave in honor of the Lord Jesus Christ. And in this dinner, there was great company. Maybe his friends, the publicans, the tax collector, they were moved by the kindness and friendship of this new teacher. They heard about Jesus Christ and how Jesus called a tax collector who was actually looked down upon by the religious leaders of Israel. But now this new teacher called this man, who actually was considered a sinner by the religious leaders of Israel, how this new teacher called him to be one of his followers. So they assembled in his house, the house of Matthew, to see this kind, friendly, compassionate new teacher. Also, maybe Matthew, being touched by the love and compassion and kindness of our Lord Jesus Christ, made a great effort to gather as many as he can in his house and to introduce them to the new master. He was touched by the Lord Jesus Christ to the extent that he forsook all and followed him. So he wanted actually every other person to meet the Lord and their life maybe will be changed. And this is one actually of the very best ways to begin Christian service, is the method chosen by Saint Matthew. If you really are touched by the love and kindness of God, talk to others about Christ. Invite them to be in his presence. Invite them to taste and see how sweet is God. That's what Saint Matthew did. He gave a big dinner, invited many, and introduced the Savior. And in this way, he demonstrated publicly and forever his new way of life. From now on, I will not be a greedy tax collector person. No, I am a disciple of Christ. My life is changed completely. But usually, some people always, they are negative and attack anything that is done for the glory of God. So the Pharisees and the religious leaders of Israel, who knew Matthew and his occupation, he was a tax collector. Also, they knew the character of his guests. According to them, they are sinners. So they were offended that Jesus, who pretended to be a good teacher, a prophet, how he lowered himself to go and have company with such men, sinners, publicans, guest tax collector. For them, the tax collector were considered dishonest men who abused their authority by overcharging the tax rate. And the same happened when the Lord said to Zacchaeus, I will go and stay in your house. They were offended and they said, how he is going to stay at the house of a sinner? So very disrespectfully, they said to the disciples, why do you eat and drink with tax collector and sinners? If you are claiming that you are godly people and your teacher is a prophet, why you are sitting and eating with tax collectors and sinners? So, although they directed their words to the disciples, not to the Lord Jesus Christ, according to Saint Luke, but knowing that their intention to direct these words to the Lord Jesus Christ himself, so the Lord Jesus took up the case here and vindicates his disciples and himself by telling them the physician proverb, as we read in verse 31. Jesus answered and said to them, "Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. I have not come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance." Those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. This was one of those sayings of the Lord which sank very deep into the hearts of the hearers. All the three evangelists, Matthew, Mark, and Luke, repeated the same verse. And here actually the Lord is explaining to them the reason why he is eating and drinking with the sinners and tax collectors. He was among them because he is the great physician. So he said, those who are in good health, or those who believe that they are in good health, those who believe they are free from all diseases, they stand as if they don't need assistance of any physician. So you, the scribes and Pharisees, in your own opinion, you believe that you are free from the disease of sin. You are righteous according to the law of Moses. You are blameless. So you don't feel that you need me. I am the physician who came to cure the maladies of the souls as well as the bodies of men. Nowadays, many people believe they don't need God, and they deny the existence of God. Or they say, I don't know whether he exists or he doesn't exist. Agnostic, I don't know. As if this knowledge is not important for them. Or they don't need the church. They can survive without the church. Because they believe they are righteous. They believe they don't need God. They are like the scribe and Pharisees, judging everybody, and they are righteous. But such persons who are sick with sin, who are sensible of it and desire healing. So he is there for them. He came to cure and to save them. That's why he conversed with the sinners. That's why even on the cross, in the peak of his suffering, when he heard the thief praying and talking with him, he assured him of his salvation. So his ministry as a physician, lying among the sinners, not among those who believe they are righteous. And here the Lord did not dispute that their form of righteousness is false. Because even if he told them, your righteousness is false one, they would not heed him. People who are prideful, they don't listen to any advice or any correction. They're wise in their own eyes. But this type of righteousness is dangerous righteousness. Because this righteousness produces a man whose heart is very proud and fails to see their personal needs for God's gift. They don't need the righteousness of Christ. They trust their own righteousness. And actually, if we reflect on the people who are sitting there, the most people who consider themselves sinners, they were healed. But the people who were indeed in real need of the true physicians, they were not healed because of their pride, their arrogance. So the Lord here did not admit that these people are spiritually healthy, but he told them, you believe that you are healthy, then let it be. They viewed themselves as righteous. And that's why they attacked the Lord Jesus Christ and the disciples, because he was sitting with the tax collectors and the sinners based on their prejudice. So the word of our Lord Jesus Christ, the well do not need a physician but the sick, these words has both obvious meaning and deeper meaning. So as the ordinary duties and responsibilities of life, these scribes and Pharisees were really whole. If we compared to them or evaluated them according to the righteousness of the law, they were whole. They were not sinners like the tax collectors. So that's the obvious meaning. But the deeper meaning, the scribes and the Pharisees were more sinners than the tax collectors. You know why? Because at least the tax collectors, they know they are sinners and they admit it. But these people, they were more sinners, more sinful, but they did not admit it. In the definition of difficult people, who are the difficult people? The difficult people are not the people who have problems. But the difficult people are the people who have problems and they don't recognize or realize that they have problems. For example, if I am addict and I know I have a problem, I will be treated. But if I am addict and I'm in denial that I have problem, that's actually the more difficult case. People who are in denial. So, who are the more sinful people in this setting? Not the tax collectors, but the Pharisees and the scribes. But his mission, our Lord, he came to seek and to save those who are lost. He came to both the elder son and the prodigal son. But unfortunately, the elder son did not benefit from him, but the prodigal son benefited from him. Those who believe that they are in the sheepfold, they did not benefit from the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. But those who realize that they are the lost sheep, they benefited from the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ. Saint Matthew, in his gospel, when he wrote this story, he mentioned another thing that Luke did not mention in his gospel, that the Lord rebuked their arrogance and their merciless superiority by telling them, go and learn, I desire mercy and not sacrifice. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. You can offer sacrifices as much as you can, but if you don't have a merciful heart, you will not be accepted, and all your sacrifices will not be accepted. It was the glory of our Lord that He came to heal the moral and spiritual sickness that overcame all people. And the Pharisees themselves were included in this if they had only been able to appreciate it and to accept the healing. So the Lord came even to the Pharisees. He came to His own, but His own did not accept Him, as St. John said in his gospel. So when the Lord actually answered them wisely, and they could not continue their argument, so now they start to look at another thing from spiritual perspective to condemn the Lord. So after the Lord answered them wisely why He is sitting among the scribes, among the tax collectors and the publicans, and they didn't know how to answer Him back, then they asked a question about fasting. Then they said to Him, why do the disciples of John fast often and make prayers, and likewise those of Pharisees, but yours eat and drink? So now they want to discredit Him. You are saying you are a physician, but John the Baptist, who is a great teacher, everybody in Judea and Israel admits that John the Baptist is a great teacher, a great prophet. So his disciples fasting, and the Pharisees also, his disciples are fasting. But why your disciples are not fasting? They are eating and drinking. The practice of fasting was seen as an expression of humility before God, of mourning, repentance, spiritual purification. So as if they are saying Him, you are coming to call people to repentance, but why you are not teaching them to fast? So this was an effort by Pharisees to open a conflict between Jesus and John the Baptist. John the Baptist was admired by all the people. So if they succeeded actually to create this conflict between Jesus and John the Baptist, then their goal to discredit the Lord Jesus Christ would be successful. We learn from the Gospel of St. Mark that who asked this question to the Lord Jesus Christ? The disciples of John the Baptist as well as the disciples of Pharisees. So the disciples of John the Baptist and the disciples of the Pharisees were united together in this occasion. Perhaps how the Lord conducted His life, His presence at feastings, His association with the publicans, His choice of one of them like Matthew to be one of His disciples, all these surprised and disturbed some of the followers of John the Baptist, because John was ascetic. So the Lord actually, to answer them, He gave them four illustrations. He told them, and he said to them, "Can you make the friends of the bridegroom fast while the bridegroom is with them?" That's the first illustration. But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast in those days. The second illustration. Then he spoke a parable to them. No one puts a piece from a new garment on an old one. Otherwise, the new makes a tear. And also, the piece that was taken out of the new does not match the old. The third illustration. And no one puts new wine into old wineskins, or else the new wine will burst the wineskins and be spilled, and the wineskins will be ruined. But new wine must be put into new wineskins, and both are preserved. And the last illustration, he told them, and no one having drunk old wine immediately desires new, for he says the old is better. So these are the four illustrations. First one, feasting and fasting. While the bridegroom is here, we cannot fast. Second illustration, new patch on old garment. Third illustration, new wine in old wine skins. Fourth illustration, drinking new wine after drinking old wine. So, the Lord, to answer the question of fasting, he used this for illustration. He started with analogy with which they would be familiar, the Jewish wedding ceremony. The Jewish wedding ceremony. Fasting and mourning would be absurd at a wedding. Wedding are feasting and joy. And also, John the Baptist testified about the Lord Jesus Christ, and he said he is the bridegroom. He said, "I am not the bridegroom. I am the friend of the bridegroom." So even John the Baptist testified about the Lord Jesus Christ, he's the bridegroom. So there is celebration, there is feast. John the Baptist also said, "Then my joy is fulfilled." So this is a time of joy. As we read in John chapter 3, John the Baptist pointed to Jesus as the bridegroom, and he told them that coming of the bridegroom was the fulfilling of his joy. So this now is a rejoicing time, time of joy. Of course, the Lord did not reject the notion of fasting. And the church of the new covenant, our church, will practice fasting and prayer. He said to the disciples about the devil, "This kind cannot come out by anything except by prayer and fasting." And he told them, when the bridegroom will be taken up to heaven, they will fast. So the Lord did not deny the concept of fasting, but he told them, this present time is not the time of fasting. But when the time comes, when he will be taken away, it will be the appropriate time to fast. And this actually verse about taken away is one of the earliest recorded public hint of his crucifixion, resurrection, and ascension to heaven. Although it was vague, and many people did not understand what he meant when the bridegroom will be taken away. He said a similar thing to Nicodemus when he said to Nicodemus in John chapter 3, when the Son of Man be lifted up. And we knew that after the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, the disciples fasted. And we read in the book of Acts, many times people, the disciples were fasting, like in Acts chapter 13, in Acts chapter 20, many references. Also, St. John Chrysostom said, he is again establishing his argument by illustration from common life. And what he says is like this. The disciples have not yet become strong. They have not yet been renewed by the Spirit. And on persons in that state, one ought not to lay any burden of injunctions. These are the words of John Chrysostom. So he said, I will teach the disciples gradually, step by step. The second illustration is about new patch on old garment. The third one, new wine in old wine skins. The fourth one, new wine and old wine. In these three illustrations, the meaning is very similar. And the point that the Lord Jesus Christ wanted to make, that we cannot fit his new life, his new covenant, into old forms. For example, patching up an old garment with a piece of new garment not only disfigures the new garment, but also causes the old garment to be more ragged than ever. Because the new piece will shrink, then pulls the old worn out garment into pieces and will tear it into pieces. The same about the wine skins. The skins of animals were sewn together to make bags for wine. The strength of newly fermented wine caused the wine skin to expand. New skins have the capacity to expand. But if new wine is put into old wine skins that have expanded already to their limit, then the container will burst. So, in these parables, the comparison is about the incompatibility of the old with the new. So, all this illustration about the old covenant given to Moses in Sinai and the new covenant in Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ came to introduce new covenant, not to patch up the old with the new. And this is, salvation is all about this. The Lord did not destroy the old, but he fulfilled the old on our behalf, and then he gave us his own righteousness as a gift. He came to wipe out what's old and to establish what's new. He came to crucify the old man and to grant us new and spiritual man. The fourth illustration is very important. He said, no one having drunk old wine immediately desires new, for he says the old is bitter. Getting used to certain type of spirituality or righteousness, you will not give it up quickly. So the Lord Jesus Christ now identifies a problem with those who believe they are satisfied with the old wine, like the scribe and the Pharisees. They are satisfied with the righteousness that came from the law. That's why they were resisting the new righteousness, the righteousness of Christ that was offered to them. because they believe the good, the old is good for them. They don't need this free righteousness of grace. So this example stresses the unwillingness of the Lord Jesus Christ to make the ceremonial fasts of the Old Testament a large feature of his new kingdom. That's why he did not fast any of these old fasts of the Old Covenant, because he wanted to establish new wineskins. These are the disciples who would be able to receive the new teaching. And Jesus' understanding of the fact that many of John's disciples, many of the Pharisees' disciples, would prefer old ways of righteousness to the new methods of approaching the kingdom of heaven. So Jesus would not, as soon as he had called his disciples out of the world, to put them on strictness and austerities of discipleship, lest they should be tempted and leave him. Even when God took the people outside Egypt, Israel came from the land of Egypt, he would not bring them by the way of Philistines, lest they should regret when they saw war and returned to Egypt. So Christ wanted to train up his followers gradually to the discipline of his family, the new covenant. Because no man, having drunk old wine, will all of a sudden, straight away, desire new wine. But he will say the old is better, because he has been used to it. So the disciples will be tempted to think their old ways of living is better, till they are by degree trained up to this new way, new covenant. So the warning is that those who refuse to embrace the message of the Lord Jesus Christ, his message of salvation, and his establishment of the kingdom of heaven, they closed their minds and hearts to his mission. They actually will miss the best that God can offer them, the righteousness of Christ, which actually is the foundation of the new covenant that God promised us through Jeremiah 600 years before Christ. It is the new covenant promised by Jeremiah that God will provide the new wine of the Eucharist to nourish his people on their journey of salvation. This actually concludes chapter 5. In a few minutes, I like to give a summary in Arabic. بسرعة كده الجزء اللي احنا اخدناه في البايبل استادي النهاردة عبارة عن نقطتين: دعوة ماثيو متى واللي اسم تاني اسمه لاوي، والجزء التاني المناقشة اللي حصلت في بيت متى ما بين السيد المسيح وما بين الفريسيين. فنعرف آية 27 يقول: وبعد هذا خرج فنظر عشارا اسمه لاوي. العشار ده دولت كانوا بيجمعوا الضرائب من الناس، وكانت الدولة الرومانية بيجي واحد يروح يدفع للدولة الرومانية يقول لهم هي العشور بتاعة المدينة دي كام، يقولوا له المبلغ الفلاني، سيروح هو يدفع عشور المدينة كلها. نظير كده كانت الدولة الرومانية تديله الحق انه يجمع من الناس اللي هو عايز يجمع، هم خلاص خدوا الفلوس اللي عايزينها، فممكن يجمع أضعاف اللي هو دفعه، وبيديرهم حق يستخدموا العنف في جمع المال ده. مش كده العشرين كانوا مكروهين جدا، كانوا ناس متسلطين، عنفاء، طماعين، فكانوا ناس ما يحبهمش ابدا. فده واحد عشار اسمه لاوي كان قاعد في مكان الجباية، المكان اللي هو بيجمع فيه الضرائب وبيجيبوا له الناس وبياخد منهم الضرائب. فربنا قال له اتبعني. ده دليل ان ربنا ما بينظرش حسب الظاهر، ربنا نظر الى قلب لاوي اللي هو متى، وشاف انه من الظاهر هو انسان شرير طماع محب للمال قاسي، لكن ربنا عارف من جواه قلبه كويس، ولو ربنا دعاه هيقدم توبة ويترك كل شيء. لكن احنا لو هنختار تلاميذ لينا في وقت السيد المسيح كنا هنختار من الفريسيين والكتبة والقادة الدينيين. ربما لو واحد قال لنا لاوي ده ينفع يبقى واحد من الخدام كنا نقول لاوي ده ينفع ازاي، ده ما ينفعش ابدا. لكن الله ينظر الى القلب، قال له اتبعني. الحاجة العجيبة اللي عملها الانسان الخاطئ العشار ده، يقول فترك كل شيء وقام وتبعه. اكيد كان سمع على المسيح، وعلش كده لما جه المسيح المعلم اللي سمعته انتشرت في كل المنطقة دي قال له اتبعني، كانش مصدق نفسه. بمعقول انا الخاطئ اللي الناس كلها بتحتقرني، اللي الناس كلها بتكرهني، انت بتقول لي اتبعني؟ الكلمات دي كان ليها تأثير جبار على قلب لاوي، وعلشان كده immediately ترك كل شيء. ده قرار مش سهل ان الواحد يترك كل شيء ويتبع ربنا، ترك كل شيء واتبع ربنا. لاوي كان عنده غيرة لأصدقائه، فراح عمل ضيافة كبيرة في بيته، ويقول والذين كانوا متكئين معهم كانوا جمعا كثيرا من عشارين وآخرين. لما بقى كل أصحابه، واللي خلينا برضه أقول لكم إن كان عنده غيرة إنه يعرف الناس، هو كتب إنجيله لليهود. يعني حتى ما اكتفاش بالضيافة دي إن جاب الناس ويقابلوا المسيح، إنما كتب إنجيله، وفي كل الإنجيل بتاعه قعد يقنعهم بآيات من العهد القديم إن يسوع ده هو المسيح. وبرضه الناس لما قال لهم يلا تعالوا نقعد، ده يسوع جاي عندي النهاردة، وهم سمعوا على المعلم ده فكانوا مبسوطين ان هم هيقعدوا مع المعلم ده، خصوصا ان العشرين دولت كانوا منبوزين من كل الناس ومكروهين، فما كانوش برضو مصدقين ان المعلم الجديد ده اللي اسمه يسوع ده وافق انه يقعد معاهم ويكلمهم ويتعشى معاهم. ف جم بأعداد كبيرة في بيت لاوي، ولاوي ده باسمه متى، ومتى معناها عطية الله. وفعلا متى في الحقيقة هو عطية الله، لأنه عن طريق إنجيله قدر يجيب ناس كتيرة من اليهود إلى المسيحية، وأيضا هو كرز يعني حسب التقليد في بلاد الحبشة. مين بقى كان موجود؟ مين دايما في ناس كده دايما يشوفوا كل حاجة سلبية ودايما ينتقدوا كل حاجة، ماشيين بحجارة في ايديهم عمالين يرموها على يسوع وتلاميذه، اللي هم مين؟ للأسف القادة الدينيين بتوع اسرائيل، الفريسيين والكتب. يقول فتذمر كتبتهم والفريسيون على تلاميذه قائلين، ما قدروش يواجهوا المسيح، فابتدوا يوجهوا كلامهم لمين؟ للتلاميذ. لكن في نيتهم هم عايزين يقولوا لمين؟ يقولوا لسيد المسيح، ان عايزين يقولوا له هو انت المعلم الصالح؟ لا مش انت. بس ما قدروش يواجهوا سيد المسيح، كان له مهابة، فما قدروش يقف قصاده، فراح كلموا التلاميذ وراح قالوا له لماذا تأكلون وتشربون مع عشارين وخطاء؟ الفريسين ما كانوش يقعدوا ابدا مع العشرين والخطاة، ما كانوش يرحبوا بيهم، بيعتبروا ان ده نجاسة بالنسبة لهم ان يقعدوا مع العشرين والخطاة. سيد المسيح فحص قلوب الكلى، عرف بالحوار ده، فرح رد ودافع عن التلاميذ وشرح لهم موقفه. قال لهم بص يا جماعة، لا يحتاج الأصحاء إلى طبيب بل المرضى. هنا السيد المسيح مش بيعترف ان هم أصحاء، لا، عايز لهم انتوا في أعين أنفسكم بتقولوا ان انتوا أصحاء، فانتوا مش حاسين انكم محتاجين لي. لكن المريض اللي شعر بمرضه هو ده اللي حاسس انه محتاج لي، وانا جيت للمريض اللي شعر بمرضه لان التانيين رفضني، برغم انا جاي ليهم برضه بس هم رفضني. ازاي اقدر اعمل واحد او احاول ان اتعامل مع واحد هو رفضني؟ عارفين زي في سفر الرؤيا كنيسة لاوديكيا يقول لاني انا غني وقد استغنيت وليس لي حاجة بشيء، وطرد المسيح. بعدين المسيح بيقول انا واقف على الباب واقرع، بره، قال له بره، مش عايزينك. وده مجتمعنا الحالي، مش عايزين ربنا الحاد، ناس بتمشي حياتها بنفسها حسب رؤيتها. دع عنك هذا الانجيل. فهنا ربنا قال لهم انتوا اصحاء، مش كنتوا مش شاعرين انكم محتاجين لي، لكن العشرين والخطاة دولت مرضى، وانا جيت عشان خاطرهم. لم اتي لادعو ابرارا. يعني ايه لم اتي لادعو ابرارا؟ الناس اللي هي بتظن ان هم ابرار مش هيستفيدوا من مجيئي، اللي هيستفيد من مجيئي هم اللي شعر انه خاطي، هو ده اللي هيستفيد من مجيئي. لم اتي لادعو ابرارا بل خطاة الى التوبة. في خدمة السيد المسيح اكتر ناس قوموه اللي كانوا شعارين ان هم ابرار، واكتر ناس استفادوا من خدمته اللي كانوا شعارين ان هم خطا. عارف زي النهاردة مثلا تلاقي مين اكتر ناس متعبة؟ اللي هم مش شايفين ضعفاتهم. يعني واحد مدمن مثلا حاسس ما عندوش مشكلة، طب ده هتعالجه ازاي؟ انما لو جاء الى ما عندي مشكلة، المشكلة تحل، تعرف تعالجه. المشكلة الحقيقية في حياة القداسة لما الانسان يشعر انه قديس ومش محتاج توبة. وده تعرفوا ازاي؟ تلاقي عمال يدين كل الناس اللي حواليه زي الكتب والفريسين، ماسك حجارة وعمال يرميها على الآخرين بدل ما يشوف خطاياه. ما عرفوش يجاوب المسيح، جاوب إجابة مقنعة جدا. فيعملوا ايه بقى؟ هم عايزين ينقضوا تعليم المسيح. قالوا طب نسأل بقى في حاجة دينية، مش انت معلم صالح؟ طيب احنا عندنا معلم دلوقتي اسمه يوحنا المعمدان، كل الناس متفقه عليه انه ده فعلا من عند ربنا، الكتب والفريسيين والخطاة والعشرين الكل بيشهد ليوحنا المعمدان، وانت بتشهد له برضه، وانت رحت اتعمدت منه، ليه انت بقى ماشي ضد يوحنا المعمدان؟ تلاميذ الفريسيين وتلاميذ يوحنا بيصوموا كتير، انما انت ما بتصومش ولا تلاميذك بيصوم. لماذا يصوم تلاميذ يوحنا كثيرا ويقدمون طلبات وكذلك تلاميذ الفريسيين ايضا، اما تلاميذك فياكلون ويشربون؟ دي احيانا تلاقي لما يكون واحد عايز يهاجم حد فيفشل فيروح يدور على حاجه تانية، واخده الثياب الروحية علشان يهاجم بيها.
فهم عملوا كده. يعني التكنيك ده معروف من ايام الكتب والفريسيين. فربنا علشان يجاوب على الحتة دي استخدم اربع امثلة. بس قبل ما اقول الاربع امثلة، ربنا جاي زي ما ارميا قال عشان يبتدي عهد جديد. يعني ايه يبتدي عهد جديد؟ العهد القديم مبني على اعمال الانسان، يعني في البداية انت خاطي وعندك شوط وصايا، لو حفظت على الوصايا دي هتبقى بار. ده العهد القديم، احنا كلنا خطاة، احفظ الوصايا دي تبقى بار. هل في حد قدر يحفظ الوصايا؟ ولا واحد. عشان كده الجميع زاغوا وفسدوا وعوزهم مجد الله، ليس من يعمل صلاحا ليس الواحد. فيبقى المعاهدة الاولى فشلت انها تبرر الناس. فربنا زي ما ارميا قال جي بقى بعهد جديد، بمعاهدة تاني، باتفاقية جديدة. الاتفاقية دي ان ربنا هياخد بشريتنا ويتمم كل بر الناموس بدلنا، زي ما قال يوحنا المعمدان ينبغي ان نكمل كل بر، وبعدين يديني البر ده عطية مجانية، هاخد بر المسيح هاخده في المعمودية لما ندفن في مية المعمودية مع المسيح وأقوم إنسان جديد، يبقى أنا خدت البر. في المعاهدة القديمة الستارتنج بوينت، نقطة البداية، أنك خاطي واعمل الوصايا عشان تحيا. إنما في العهد الجديد بعد المعمودية الستارتنج بوينت أنت إيه؟ أنت بار. والكنيسة بتشرحها بطريقة لطيفة، يلبسوا المتعمد ده ثياب بيضاء، أنت بقيت بار، بس البر ده انت واخده بدم المسيح، فيحطوا له زنار احمر على هيئه صليب كده. فهنا نقطه البدايه انت بار. حافظ على الوصايا عشان تحافظ على برك ده. طب ولو انا وقعت ازاي اقدر ابرر نفسي تاني؟ قال لك مش هتقدر تبرر نفسك، لكن تعال اقول انا غلطان، انا وقعت في الخطيه، سر التوبه والاعتراف، وتعال خد من دم المسيح الموجود على المذبح، دم يسوع المسيح طهرنا من كل خطيه، تتبرر تاني وتفضل الثياب بيضاء. زي في سفر الرؤيا لما شاف ناس ماشيه بثياب بيضاء قال مين هؤلاء؟ قال دولت اللي غسلوا ثيابهم في دم الخروف. فدي العهد الجديد، ده الفرق بين العهد القديم والعهد الجديد. فربنا قال ما ينفعش ان انا الخبط الاثنين مع بعض. انا جيت عشان اتمم العهد القديم، اتمم بر الناموس، وبعدين اديك كل بر ده كعطيه مجانيه، وبعدين تبتدوا بقى الممارسات بتاعه العهد الجديد. فسيد المسيح علشان يجاوبهم على حكايه ليه التلاميذ بتوعه ما بيصوموش، قال لهم اربع حاجات. ثلاثه منهم بيشرح حكايه الجديد والقديم، بس واحدة منهم لها علاقة بشهادة يوحنا المعمدان نفسه عن المسيح. مش هم عايزين يوقعوا مع يوحنا؟ التلاميذ يوحنا بيصوموا وتلاميذه ما بيصوموش؟ قال له طب هو يوحنا قال عني ايه؟ قال عني ان انا العريس، قال من له العروس فهو العريس، وقال عن نفسه انه ده صديق العريس، وقال اذا فرحي هذا قد كمل. يبقى احنا في عرس دلوقتي، يبقى احنا في وقت فرح. طب انتوا عندكم في الافراح بتصوموا؟ ما بتصوموش. عشان كده قال لهم اتقدرون ان تجعلوا بني العرس يصومون ما دام العريس معهم؟ ما ينفعش. ولكن ستاتي ايام حين يرفع العريس، ما فهموش يعني حين يرفع العريس عنهم، لكن دي اشاره للصليب والقيامه والصعود، فحينئذ يصومون في تلك الايام. يعني اذا في صيام في العهد الجديد، بس يختلف عن صيام العهد القديم. صيام العهد القديم ده محاولة لتبرير الإنسان، إنما صيام العهد الجديد ده حفاظ على البر اللي أنا أخدته من المسيح عطية مجانية. أقمع جسدي وأستعبده لألا بعدما كرست لآخرين أصير أنا نفسي مرفوضا. ده نوع من أنواع قمع الجسد. فده التفسير الأولاني. قال لهم فاحنا في وقت عرس. وفعلا التلاميذ بعد صعود المسيح صاموا، تعرف سفر الاعمال اكتر من ريفرنس ان هم صاموا. وبعدين بقى اشرح لهم حكايه الجديد والقديم. قال لهم طيب لو انت عندك جلبيه قديمه ثوب عتيق، تجيب رقعه من ثوب جديد وتحطها على العتيق؟ مش هينفع، لان القطعه الجديده دي هتشد العتيق فتجعل الخرق أردى، والعتيق لا توافقه الرقعة التي من الجديد. فالمسيح جاي مش عشان يعمل كده، يحط جديد على قديم، يحط العهد الجديد على العهد القديم، يحافظ على الناموس والختان والتطهيرات، وفي نفس الوقت يقول لك لا ده المعمودية والأسرار هي اللي بتدين الحاجة الجديد. ما ينفعش حط الاثنين مع بعض. فقال لهم نفس الكلام، الصلاة والصوم وكل الممارسات دي لازم تبتدي على العهد الجديد. ما ينفعش ليس أحد يضع رقعة من ثوب جديد على ثوب عتيق، وإلا فالجديد يشقه والعتيق لا توافق الرقعة التي من الجديد. إنهم المثال الثالث كانوا يجيبوا جلود الحيوانات ويعملوا منها الزقاق بتاع الخمر. فالخمر الجديدة دي بتخلي الجلد يتمدد، فلما يكون جلد جديد ممكن يتمدد، لكن لو هو جلد قديم خلاص هو تمدد لنهايته ما قدرش يتمدد أكثر من كده، فتحط فيه الخمر الجديد يروح مفرع. فقال لهم ليس أحد يجعل خمرا جديدا في زقاق عتيق لألا تشق الخمر الجديد الزقاق فهي تهرق والزقاق تتلف. الخمر الجديد هو تعليم المسيح، والزقاق هو احنا تلاميذ المسيح. فلازم احنا نتجدد الاول بالمعمودية، ولما نتجدد نبتدي نعيش الحياة الجديدة مع المسيح. اما بل يجعلون خمرا جديدة في زقاق جديدة فتحفظ جميعا. اخر آية بقى ده اللي هو الالستريشن الرابع او المثل الرابع، قال لهم ولو واحد متعود يشرب العتيق هتجيب له الجديد؟ يقول لك اللي نعرفه احسن من اللي ما نعرفوش. ليس احد اذا شرب العتيق يريد للوقت الجديد لانه يقول العتيق اطيب، انا واخد على ده. هي مشكلة الكتب والفريسيين، كتب والفريسيين كانوا يؤمنوا ان بر الناموس ده احسن لهم، ما عندهمش الإيمان الكافي إن هم يثقوا في البر اللي هيعطيهم المسيح، عشان كده رفضوا بر المسيح. وما زالوا لغاية النهاردة إسرائيل بتحاول إنها تتبرر بأعمالها ورفضين بر المسيح، العطية المجانية، لأنه بيقولوا العتيق أطيب. وده ما إحنا برضو في حياتنا أحيانا مش عايزين نتجدد بفكر المسيح، وتلاقي الواحد ماشي برضو بأسلوبه القديم. التوبة مفروض يكون فيها تغيير، زي ما بولس الرسول يقول تغيروا عن شكلكم بتجديد أذهانكم. يبقى عندنا فكر المسيح، ده الفكر الجديد، أما نحن فلنا فكر المسيح. لكن ناس كتير بتقول العتيق أطيب. فهنا ربنا قال لهم أنا لو هاجي للتلاميذ فجأة وقال لهم بصوا هو ده العهد الجديد، هو ده الطريق اللي تمشوا بيها، هيبقى صعب. فأنا بنقلهم جرادولي، بنقلهم سنة سنة، لغاية لما ياخدوا جدة الحياة، وبعد كده أحط الخمر الجديدة، فهم هيتذوقوا حلاوة الخمر الجديدة ومش هيقولوا العتيق أطيب. فهنا سيد المسيح رد عليهم بأربع إلستريشن: العريس، الرقعة الجديدة والثياب القديمة، الزقاق، وأيضا الخمر القديم والخمر العتيق. ده ينهي البايبل ستادي النهاردة بتاعتنا. لإلهنا المجد الدائم إلى الأبد، آمين.
Nein tekirini oin soften bekle. Sosiemon ovon oinon okechiet charisem oisestimet oivin temel chiesar. Temet chenloem teakum bero irain teman sonsar. Pekatet sot bente dobi tisofeya in tesolo. Vevnum mubarak litom vetom ijen ni apostolo. Shoysa veare on chenemta oirat fin benyoz tayot en arsheret. Quadros, nimbiniot in evis cobus avaius, not in tes veb da groi, genuis ronos in admission rombi on senioin irini. Tes veioin no gaji tiros avisitim noel shalom gencor, tobebe Christos eri egon tifken in novin animul chino eri gadavim neste noin kirie leiso, kirie leiso, kirie flugis on eminis hoerois hoerois. Tematania konie urgum vies mons.
Christus benuti.
Amin es shovin.
O King of peace, grant us your peace, establish for us your peace, forgive us our sins. For yours is the power, glory, blessing, and majesty forever. Amen. O Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil one. Christ Jesus, our Lord, for thine the kingdom.
Now, love of God the Father, the grace of his only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, come here and gift of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Go in peace, may the peace of the Lord be with you all. Amen.